Hi, welcome to my channel, and today I'm going to be doing my first Bookfulness unboxing. So as you know, recently I have stopped my Fairy Loot. I uploaded my last ever Fairy Loot unboxing, and in its place I've got two different book boxes. I've got my Chronicle book box, which I did an unboxing for in May, and that comes every 3 months, so my next one will be August, and then in between that I'm going to hopefully get Bookfulness, which is a monthly box, and it does work out just a tiny bit more expensive than Fairy Loot, but seeing as I'm getting two book boxes, I think it's fully worth it. So Bookfulness, it's a small little company, I think it's in Wales, mother and daughter. And these ones, you give them your favourite genre and I think they give you a book that's close to that genre, so I'm hoping it'll be pretty good. I've only ever seen one unboxing for this and it looks so cute and adorable, so I thought I'd try it out. So let's get this open. So first, there's just a little card and it says, "Hi Sophie, thanks for ordering. Wonder often, wonder always. Love the Bookfulness team." And there's just a little spoilers in there as well, but I think that's so cute. You get them all personalised and stuff. First thing I see is lots of tea. When you do sign up, you say your favourite hot drink, so you can have tea, coffee, hot chocolate. And I put tea, so they've got all of this. This is Welsh brew tea. Tea pack and blended for Wales. So you've got all of these, so those will last me for quite a while. So that's pretty good. I always do love tea, except now that it is getting a bit warmer, I drink less of it. It is more of a cold weather drink, but that will help me get through just loads of little tea. I think I do have to start maybe having a hot drink every time I have a tea, because recently I've been having Wittard's instant tea and it's like a powder. And there's one called Dreamtime that my mother got me. I always like to have that before I go to bed because it's like honey and stuff, something that's good for you before bed. But I think those will be very, very good. And then these are, oh wow, they are marshmallows. Vanilla marshmallows coated in milk chocolate. I think that is something that when I tell my boyfriend, he will love those. It's got no nuts in, so that is great. It's handmade in England, 100% natural and no artificial colours or flavours. And that is by Mellow and Marsh. So marshmallows are just amazing. I love how you get food in these. And I think I also did mention that I do have a nut allergy, I think. So this just makes the box even more better because it's all for when you get food and they've all got nuts in, so you can't have any. And then you have nice little woolen socks. So with this box, I am basically thinking of winter time in autumn, you know, just going away, taking some tea and marshmallows and maybe making s'mores and stuff. Because these socks, probably won't wear them until winter, but you can never have too many socks, especially fluffy socks, because these are so nice and fluffy. Then you've got some hand cream and it's rose and almond. So I mustn't have put that I'm allergic to nuts, because obviously almonds I can't have, so I may have to give that away. But just a cute little hand cream, handmade in Manchester, England, and that's Bahari Blossom. It's very, very cute and adorable, just a shame that it's almond. If it was just rose, it would be perfect, but unfortunately not. This is the book. So with Bookfulness, you do only get the paperback, but I think that's why it makes it so cheap and adorable. Also very, very light. It comes by Royal Mail, whereas a lot of other book boxes, they come by like a courier or something. The book is The Stars Are Fire by Anita Shreve, and no idea what this is about, but the blurb says 1947. Fires are racing along the coast of Maine after summer-long drought, ravaging thousands of acres, causing unprecedented confusion and fear. 5 months pregnant, Grace Holland is left alone to protect her two toddlers when her moody and unpredictable husband, Jean, joins volunteers fighting to bring the fire under control. Along with her best friend, Rosie, and Rosie's two young children, the women watching horror as their houses go up in flames, then walk into the ocean as a last resort. They spend the night frantically trying to save their children. When dawn comes, they have miraculously, I cannot say that word, survived, but their lives are changed forever. And Grace's bravery is tested as never before. That seems like it might be a bit interesting. At first look, it doesn't look like the kind of thing I would read. I can't wait to give it a go. I mean, this is why I decided to cancel Fairy Loot. So I wanted to try something different, something that's based towards adult. And this is obviously historic fiction. And I think it'll be very, very interesting because it's kind of out of my comfort zone. Historic fiction is generally, you know, Victorian times and the world wars as well. but yeah, I can't wait to give that a go. So that's my first bookfulness unboxing, and I think it is very, very cute and adorable, to be honest. I can't wait to try these, and I will have to go get some milk before I have my tea as well, because I've never had Welsh tea, and I do love how it is UK based, so I love anything UK based. It's a small company as well, and it's nice to feel like you're just helping out other people. So yeah, that's it. If you are interested, I will link them below so you can have a look. It is cheap, and you can get a taster box as well, which is just a lot smaller, so if you're not too sure, you can try that out instead. So like I said, I'll link that below, my social media is below, and I'll see you later with a new video. Bye.